Okay, this is part two of the adventure of the raised high bed. High bed. Now there's my foot. There's my leg. Let's see. I'm 5'2", so it goes about to the middle of my... Well, let's see. Let's see how tall it is. Whew, I've been out here working, and I was going to turn it on, but I thought, you know, nothing as irritating as the drill going, and you can, like, figure out what I did. But I'm going to show you in a minute. Let's see how tall this is. I even got my tape measure out. Okay, it's 31 inches. 31 inches off the ground. I'm 5'2", so it's cool. Look, my hands. My hands are right here. I'm standing up, so it's going to be like the perfect height for me. I'm thinking of making this a bench, a workbench. I have one workbench. Oh, yeah, I could have a really cool workbench. Good idea. But I figured it out. I actually had to change these parts out because they're different. I think some are the top and some are the bottom. And so I got the bigger ones, and it was off like a half an inch, this side to that side, but I don't think you can tell. And I thought, you know, I can adjust the dirt or sits in or brick or whatever I set it on. So here's what I did. I adjusted it, so I'll show you on this one. See how it's got that cross piece right there? And there's the cross piece right here. And this had this and this. So I made sure this sat on here. And I did over here too. And these probably should go on the bottom where the rollers go, but I put it up the other way because it is upside down. And I thought, well, I could put some dowel or something in there. Yeah, maybe rebar or something if I want to put a cover over my raised beds. Or if I use it for a workbench. Because nothing better than a nice short workbench when you're short. Nothing else I could dig in the ground. Okay, so that's what I did. So I had it on its side when I did it. And I had this propped up on both sides. And I'm not a very good screwer, although my husband would disagree. But anyway, this 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 nails. So I put them along 2 here and 2 down that way. See? And then I was going to take one of these pieces, or I guess 2. I actually had this on here when I was doing the screwing on the bottom. See how it, see with this? Oh, these are heavy though. See with that extra piece of wood there like that? You see in the shade? See? So I had that down there and then on the side. So on the bottom and on the side. I had that on there actually. I didn't screw it on. I just had it on there, which kept it the right width, I think. And then I thought, I'll try it without those two pieces on there because otherwise it's going to be too heavy. And I can always put it on there if it needs it, but I don't know if it's going to need it. And then I've decided to go get a piece of plywood. I'm going to have a piece of plywood. If this is going to be my bench, I'll have like a piece of plywood. See, so do I want to put it on the inside so I can have it cut from here to here and that length? And it would be sitting on these pieces. And then I was thinking about, you see, if this had went the other piece the other way, but it didn't go the other way, it fit this way, those pieces would have been resting. In other words, it would have been resting better. And I think, I don't know if I should put a piece of wood underneath that to hold it up. It seems pretty strong though. Yeah. Well, I can always do that. Actually, I think if I put a piece of plywood over, the weight would be distributed, and I think I just wouldn't need any more than that. And then I thought, look at these holes here. See these holes? Can you see them? Let's see. Dang thing. Yeah, see those holes there? Those are like perfect so I could put dowels across instead of wasting that good piece of wood, because I think dowels is cheaper. Wood dowels to kind of hold it together. And it's already got the holes and everything there for it. So I can put wool dowels and save this wood for something else. Because I got a lot of things I could do. Oh, look at all those raised beds. But for right now, I think this one's going to be an outdoor workbench. Yeah. Oh, I'm so proud. You should have seen me on the ground. See, I cleared this all out of here. It's a lot of junk here. And all it's been living over here is spiders and ants. So then I had this on the side. So I had to sit right there. And I'm sitting there thinking, I hope there's no spider or ant crawling up my leg. So I did it very fast. But pretty good. I put the holes in first, and then I put the screws. I had all these old screws. And I used this size screw, which is a 3-inch. No, that's not a screw. This is a 3-inch screw. Wood screw. See, it's a wood screw. I know that. And see my little old kit. A lot of this stuff I had for a long time. Is that the coolest thing you ever saw? I am so stoked, because I always wanted a nice wooden workbench, and now I got it. And I always wanted a vise, true. Wanted a vise. Shouldn't I be knitting or something? I don't know. Sewing or cooking. Instead, I'm making a cool bench. Well, a potting bench or a workbench. Anyway, I am so happy. So this is part two of my workbench or raised high beds, because they're going to be raised high, not just plain old raised bed. Raised bed is like that over there, but a raised high bed is higher, like a high bed. Okay, I'm rambling now. Oh, you see my old, I have two Makitas and two or three batteries, but whenever I need the drill, I leave them plugged in out there, and it seems like the batteries are always dead when I need them right that minute. And this old drill with the chuck key, I've had like 35 years, and I just unplug it and use the chuck in there, and it just keeps on working. Black and Decker. Okay, I think I've hurt myself, so my body is not used to this, but by the time I get done building all those, I'm going to be in so good a shape. And look how sturdy it is. Look, I'm moving it, and it don't move. That's all them screws. It does not move. Let's see, I'll hit it with my hips. Do you see it moving? Look, the whole thing moved, but it didn't waggle. So I think it's fine. Okay, I can rest now. Hey, Simic, did you like it? Do you like it? Look at his big bone. You're a good boy? Yeah, you're a good boy. Hey, you're so cute. You're so cute.